Hey, what's going on, everybody? Thomas here, and this is Buffalo Fanatics. In this video, I'm going to be talking to you guys about why I believe the Buffalo Bills will finally find their franchise quarterback in 2018. Let's go. So first off, I do want to apologize. I haven't been posting videos probably for about like 2.5-3 weeks now. And as many of you guys probably don't know, I am a college student and it is kind of hard to post videos consistently, edit them. You know, you guys probably can understand, you know, what it's like. Plus finals is just around the corner. You know, it makes it really tough. And I was like sick for over a week. It was just really, really tough to do all of it at once. So I apologize, but I'm going to try to continue to make quality content as often as I can, but bear with me guys, you know, I'm only trying to do my best here. But anyways, let's jump right into the meat and potatoes of this video. So yes, this is a huge thing if the Buffalo Bills finally get a franchise quarterback since a guy like Jim Kelly. I mean, it's been way too long. The Buffalo Bills have taken guys like Tyrod Taylor or Ryan Fitzpatrick, those kind of guys who were backups to teams, and brought them in and just kind of toyed with them and see if they could do something. And we can all agree that pretty much every single quarterback since Jim Kelly has been average or a little bit above average, but nobody even close to the Andrew Lucks, Matt Ryans, Ben Roethlisberger's, Tom Brady's of today. You know, it's just not, the Bills didn't have it. But all this time of having mediocre quarterback play for the Buffalo Bills ends in 2018, and here's why. Reason number one: Nathan Peterman. Oh boy. We already know. Nathan Peterman threw 5 interceptions, just a horrible performance. And, you know, we can all agree that probably in preseason and that Colts game that he played, he did a pretty good job. But obviously in that Colts game, you can't really throw that ball that well if you watch that game. That game was insane. But Nathan Peterman, this offseason, he worked out with quarterback guru Tom House. Now, to name a few quarterbacks that Tom House has worked with, Tom Brady, Ben Roethlisberger, Matt Ryan, Drew Brees, Andrew Luck, you know, those guys, just to name a few. And those guys are premier quarterbacks in this league. And, you know, not saying that he's going to turn out to be one of those guys, but by working with a guy that has experience working with very good quarterbacks, he might be able to take that big jump from year one to year two and maybe be fantastic. And you don't know, it's gonna be competition. We're not gonna just have those two quarterbacks on our team. We have only two quarterbacks. We're definitely drafting one. I mean, whether that be first round, second round, third round, fourth round, you know, and later rounds, you know, we're drafting a quarterback. And, you know, whatever happens, you know, the draft is Thursday, you know, so anything can happen. But the Buffalo Bills are going to get a quarterback in this draft regardless. Two quarterbacks, two unproven quarterbacks in the NFL, it's not going to cut it. They're going to need another guy to come in who is either a top prospect or a guy who they think that can fit their system and basically develop and win for them. So Nathan Peterman really could take that big jump, and I think that it's very likely. You know, people who make big mistakes in their first year usually learn from them, for the most part, or they just continue to suck. But, you know, Nathan Peterman actually could take a huge jump and be something. You know, he could. He showed flashes in preseason, now against third stringers, but, you know, he could be something good. You never know. Reason number two, AJ McCarron. Absolute beast at Alabama. I mean, go look back at his highlights, go look back at the film and the stats. I mean, it says it all. He is a college unbelievable star, basically. But he has played 4 years for Cincinnati, not really playing that many games, only four. But you know, who knows? A new city, a new team, a new coach, a new everything. Everything is new for him. And he has the chance to start. That could make him be like, you know what, this is my team now. I gotta take it over. And he could be something good. You never know. So AJ McCarron is my reason number two. You know, who knows? It's a big question mark. Is he gonna be good? Is he gonna be subpar? Is he gonna be average? What is he gonna be? It's very interesting to see how he's gonna fit in the new system, how he's gonna fit in a new city. Reason number three. Now, this one is my favorite. This is my favorite reason by far. Brandon Bean said in a press conference a few days ago, I believe, maybe a week ago or so, basically that the number one job of a general manager is to find a franchise quarterback. That is the number one thing. If you don't got a franchise quarterback, you don't got any team going to the playoffs or anything really. You know, Tyrod Taylor, you know, you needed luck to get in the playoffs. Let's just be honest. You needed luck. So, you know, without a franchise quarterback, that's going to happen to you. And with Tom Brady in your division, who is probably not going to be there that much longer, you got the Jets going up. They're at three. You know they're going to get a franchise quarterback. Now, hopefully it's a bust, whoever they pick. Maybe they pick Josh Allen and he ends up being a bust or something. But, you know, Baker Mayfield, if they go Baker Mayfield at three, then we got to play him. So, you know, you got to get a franchise quarterback to stay strong in this league, and you can't win without it, really. You can win with a subpar quarterback. Like, look at Blake Bortles in Jacksonville. You can do it, but you need an amazing, absolutely amazing defense that holds the Buffalo Bills offense to 3 points. You get what I'm saying? So the Bills don't have that amazing defense. They got a really good defense, and they're building up those trenches on the defensive line. They're building up that secondary. You know, there's still that question mark on the second cornerback and depth, but, you know, linebackers, that's what we're lacking. And we don't have the defense that Jacksonville does. So we can't really get by winning a lot of games with a decent quarterback. We need a franchise guy. And pretty much it's kind of like this. If you get a franchise quarterback, pretty much everything falls into place. If he's healthy, think about the Colts when they don't have Andrew Luck compared to when they do have Andrew Luck. They're so much better. From the beginning of the season, they're playoff contenders. But without him, they go, what, 4-12 or 3-13 or something like that? They just are horrible. You know what I mean? So you need a franchise quarterback. That's without a doubt. I think everybody agrees on that. But here's the interesting thing. Brandon Bean put that pressure on himself. No person would put that pressure on themselves if they didn't have something in place. I believe, I truly, honestly believe the Buffalo Bills are trading up to number one or number two. It's just how it is. Or he's got something in place with Browns at four or Denver at five, you know, teams that are okay with shopping their pick. But I truly believe, honestly believe, Bills are going to get a franchise quarterback. And whether that be Nathan Peterman, I know it's funny to laugh, but you never know. Whether that be AJ McCarron, who knows what he's got? We haven't really seen him play. He almost won a playoff game, for Christ's sake, you know? You know, the draft, the big six quarterbacks, one of those guys is definitely going to be a franchise quarterback. Who, though? And if the Buffalo Bills believe in, like, Sam Darnold, Josh Rosen, Baker Mayfield, you know, even Josh Allen, like, even if they trade up, you know, who knows what they really think is going to be the one. I think it's going to be very interesting to see exactly what they do, but I honestly believe, and don't even worry this draft, literally don't even worry. If Brandon Bean's going to say something like the number one job is getting a quarterback, you know, they already got something in place. That's what that tells me. So guys, rest assured knowing that this year may very well be the year. We have the draft capital. We're going to go up and get our guy. It's just a matter of waiting until Thursday and seeing what happens. But, you know, I'm pretty sure that the Bills are going to do something huge this draft. They might even jump the Jets, you know, trying to get up to one or two. And I firmly believe that I will stand by that. I will take my big fat L if I'm wrong, but I really think that the Bills are going to do everything they can to get up into that top five. I don't see how you can pass it up. I really don't. I mean, if you get a linebacker at 12 and a wide receiver at 22, good job. But you don't have a franchise quarterback. And so I really think that that's going to happen. But that's going to do it for me, everybody. If you guys enjoyed this video, please go leave a like down below. Comment your opinions. Let me know exactly what you guys are thinking. What are the Bills going to do? Is Nathan Peterman the franchise quarterback of the future? Is AJ McCarron? Is one of the rookies a franchise quarterback for the Bills? What are the Bills going to do? Are they going to trade up? Are they going to stay put? Let me know in the comments down below. I would love to see what you guys have to say. And then also, if you guys haven't subscribed already, please go subscribe to the channel for more amazing content like this every single week. And click the bell to notify you every single time we have a video so you guys never miss another upload. But anyways, that is going to do it for me, everybody. I hope you guys have an amazing day, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.